Hey guys, got a quick vlog update for you today. We're working on a ton of different projects in the shop and we don't have a video for you ready just yet. So we're gonna show you what we're working on right now. So as you know, in the last video, we showed off the Iron Man suit that we got from the armor factory. This thing is awesome. We're definitely gonna be using it for other future projects and we will do a dedicated video talking a bit more about the suit. And we'll probably be doing that within the next few weeks. So stay tuned for that. Now, the thing that everyone's waiting for is the Batman grappling hook gun with Ascension device, and the prototype is coming along great. So the really cool thing about this one is we have designed this from the ground up. It's completely custom to Hacksmith Industries. It has two 2.5 kilowatt brushless DC motors, which power a pair of worm gears, which spin a winch like this. And what that means is you'll actually be able to ascend at Batman-like speeds, which is awesome. So, we've got a clamp down the table, and we can spin it up for you to show you what it looks like in action. So that's at like 10% speed right now. Safety first. Now, it might not look like it, but that is scary powerful. If I accidentally got my hand stuck in there, my hand would be gone, which is why we've actually 3D printed a whole bunch of guards that will go around it to make sure you can't accidentally get your hand stuck in there. But the neat thing is, we're actually mounting that directly to the side of the grappling hook gun, which means it's all in one. It's going to be on the gun, you're going to shoot the gun, and then you'll have a little speed control and you'll actually be able to get sucked up by the gun, which I think is awesome. We're loosely basing this gun off of the Telltale Games Batman grappling hook gun, and we'll be doing a bit more work to make it look more like the gun from that game. Now, in addition to that, we're also working on another really fun project, which I'm super excited for. So, I actually just started snowboarding last year, and it is fantastic. I think I found the sport I love to do. But the problem is, where I live, there aren't actually many mountains nearby, which means snowboarding or even skiing is kind of difficult. You have to drive 5 hours north just to get to a small mountain, which compared to, say, Vermont or BC and Alberta, it's nothing. So what we thought was, what if you could snowboard on flat ground, kind of like longboarding? So what we're going to do is reuse some of the EDFs that we got from Hobby King for the flight project. Speaking of the flight project, that's still going on. It's just we're waiting for funding right now, and we're doing a whole bunch of tests with 3D printing. But we might as well do some other projects with the parts we already have. So what we're going to do is we'll actually have two of these EDFs stacked vertically, mounted off the back of the board, which means you'll be able to go, I think, at speeds of up to about 50 kilometers an hour on flat ground. And I'm really curious, because on a mountain, you can carve back and forth as you're going down the hill. Can you do that on flat ground? We're going to find out. And you know what? We might do it while wearing an Iron Man suit. And you might be asking, why snowboarding? It's barely winter. Well, in Canada, it is winter. This is literally like 2 days worth of snow, and it's crazy. So we're trying to get this project done soon, so we can have the video out for you within the next week or two, who knows, we'll see. But the snow is calling to me, I need to go snowboarding. And in case you're wondering, that was from our Halloween party. It's real spray paint, so it's not coming off, but we're actually getting the door replaced fairly soon because we're losing a lot of heat through this door and it's cold outside. We're burning through natural gas like no tomorrow. In addition to that, we've been doing quite a few renovations around the garage. Most notably, the back room. So originally, this room was used for storage, and that's just not an efficient use of space. So we've taken out a few walls, we've repainted the walls, and we bought a few more shelves. So we actually have the Tormach over here now. And it's got its own dedicated shelf for material, tools, you know, calipers, all that kind of stuff. And then over here we have another workbench, we've got a urinal, and this is kind of neat, this is our battery charging cabinet. So we have all our lithium polymer batteries up top, We got lead acid in the bottom, and we will have other battery chargers and whatnot for like AA and AAA batteries, as well as anything else that we can fit in here. And as you can see, we also have LED lighting to keep it nice and bright in there. We have another workbench, which we just put together. And what we're planning on doing over here is we're actually going to move the mill over to this edge. And then we're going to build a big workbench right here. Take the air conditioner out because it doesn't work anymore. Put a fan in, and then we'll actually have a fume hood, which means we'll be able to do welding, grinding, spray painting, powder coating, you name it, without risking our lungs and getting lung cancer. Also, upstairs, we've been doing a lot of 3D printing lately, and we're actually planning on doing a dedicated 3D printing video fairly soon, but I wanted to just give you a sneak peek of our 3D printing setup. So as you know, Lulzbot has been sponsoring us, and we have a TAS 5 and a TAS 6 3D printer. And what we've actually done is we've put them underneath our electronics and soldering workbench and built a heated enclosure. So we have foam here, and we actually created these doors, all 3D printed parts, and they slide open like that. We've actually got a space heater in the corner, and this entire area is heated up nice and toasty. And what that means is you can print giant parts like this. Because the problem with 3D printing large parts is they tend to warp. If you have any kind of breeze or airflow that hits it and causes the plastic to cool in a non-uniform pattern. But if you have a heated enclosure, you're able to print giant parts in ABS with minimal to none, no warping. We use ABS filament for a lot of the parts we make because it's basically the most tried and true filament out there. It's got pretty good build quality, it's very strong, and the only big problem is warping. But because we have this heated build chamber, it doesn't really matter anymore. We do have other filaments though, and we're happy to announce we actually got a sponsorship from filaments.ca, which is a website that sells all kinds of filaments. So as you can see, we're actually pretty fully stocked with a whole bunch of different kind of filaments. We've got some polycarbonate, ASA, I have no idea what that is. We have some protoplastic, iridescent, high temperature PLA. This stuff's actually really cool. It's clear, and we were impressed at how strong it was. We have some Tallman's nylon, of course. Oh, PETG. No, this is nylon, actually. The official Lulzbot green filament. I think that's also copolyester. More ABS Plus, ABSX, and a whole bunch of other stuff, and a few samples, including Ninja Tech and some Armadillo Ninja Tech. We're really excited to print with these because this is actually kind of like a rubbery filament, so you can print flexible parts, which would be really useful. And then the Armadillo, it's a bit stiffer, but apparently it has really good interlayer adhesion, and again, it's a bit more flexible than your typical plastics. So right now, we're actually 3D printing the parts for the jet-powered snowboard, and you'll be able to fit two EDFs, and you'll clamp the two together, and then there'll be a steel weldment encasing the whole thing for safety, rigidity, and protection of the EDFs, because, as you know, with snowboarding, you tend to fall a lot. So speaking of the snowboard project, let's take a look at the 3D model that we whipped up to help give us an idea of what we were going to build. Alright, so this is our quick and dirty model of the system we're planning on building for the snowboard. And as you can see, we've got the two 3D printed parts here that we just showed being printed. And what they can do is they hold the EDFs and then also the speed controllers. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to build this steel weldment which wraps around the whole thing, provides a compartment for the batteries, and then gets mounted on just below the bindings of the snowboard. So we're hoping, because we've tested this on a longboard, and we basically could go much faster than we could safely ride a longboard, but now with snow, we actually have a method of braking. So I'm thinking we might be able to hit a good 50-60 kilometers an hour on flat ground using the snowboard, which I think is fantastic and is going to be a lot of fun. All right, so that sums up the update for you today. We're going to be doing quite a few videos in the next few weeks before Christmas. I'm not sure if you guys have heard, but YouTube's changed its algorithm recently, which may affect how much our videos are seen. And it's kind of concerning for the channel because even now at close to 1 million subscribers, we're barely breaking even. It's going to be really hard for us to continue doing these projects without extra support from Patreon or if the channel grows a lot more. But the way YouTube's been changing things If you have no idea what I'm talking about, look up the Game Theory channel, and they recently did a video on the new YouTube algorithm, which is hurting original content creators. So to try and combat this new change by YouTube, we're going to be attempting to do a few different formats for our future videos. Basically, YouTube is trying to push longer form videos and more frequent videos, which I guess is good for you guys if you want to see more Hacksmith stuff. We're just worried about being able to produce that much content. So, if you guys have any suggestions about that, please let us know in the comments. Would you like to see more vlogs like this where we walk around the shop and show you what we're working on? Because something like this is very easy for us to produce, as opposed to an actual build and test video, which sometimes takes up to weeks to film and edit and do all that kind of stuff. So, if you guys don't mind seeing more vlogs, let us know and we can easily do more stuff like this. And we're also thinking about doing instructional videos. Are you guys interested in learning how to make things? We're thinking about doing like a how to weld, how to solder, maybe 3D printing basics, maybe even a video about how to build anything using a grinder and a welder, which you can buy from a hardware store for under $200 for both. And if you're interested in any of the sponsors that we have, there's some links in the description below to both our 3D printer sponsors, Lulzbot, or Alpha Objects, and of course filaments.ca, who have been kindly providing us with free filament. In addition, we always have Hobby King, because they've been giving us tons of free parts. I think they've supplied us with almost $10,000 worth of components now, which is absolutely fantastic, and it's allowed us to do a whole bunch of projects now, and we're going to be able to continue doing projects with the stuff that they've been providing us with. So please check out those sponsors. They help make things happen on this channel, and they'd love it if you checked out their sites. I think that's it. Yeah, that wasn't very funny. Anyway, I think that's it for the vlog. Stay tuned for future updates. We have tons of stuff coming. And please, if you guys haven't subscribed yet, do subscribe. We're so close to hitting 1 million subscribers, and I would love to get a gold play button to put on my wall. And according to the YouTube analytics, only about 30% of my views come from subscribers. And considering our videos get a few 100,000 views per video, that means if you guys all just hit subscribe, I'd crack 1 million overnight.